A very warm welcome to all of you in another easy PowerPoint animation tutorial video. The animation is a replication of Miner with Jackleg animation by Nick at CodePen.io. He used HTML, CSS, and JavaScript to create the entire scene and the animation effects, and we have used the flash once, spin, motion path, and fade out effects in PowerPoint. We used the shape tools to draw all the objects like the Miner, Jackleg machine, the light, smoke, and fire particles. Let's first have a look at all the shapes that we used by opening the Selection Pane from the Home tab. The Selection Pane always shows the list of objects in an order according to their position on the slide. Like, the Jackleg machine object is on top of the list, and if we use send to back command from the format shape, then it will be behind all the other objects, and the position of this object will also get changed in the Selection Pane. You must consider the placement of objects while drawing these kinds of scenes. For instance, you can also note that the body of the Miner is between the left and right leg, and the head and light are rotating behind the Jackleg machine. We have also assigned a custom anchor point to the Miner's head and light by grouping an extra oval to them. We placed that oval at a position to have an anchor point in the middle of the Miner's head because we want to spin them right from that position. Besides other objects in the presentation, you can also see that we are using 20 shapes each for smoke and fire particles. If we open the animation pane from the animations tab, then you can see a huge list of animation effects that we applied to all these objects. But you don't need to worry, as you only need to understand the concept of the top 9 animation effects, and the rest are the replication of the same 3 effects that we used for smoke and fire particles. First, we have the Jackleg drill on top in the animation pane, and we are using the blink emphasis effect with a time duration of 0.10 seconds and repeating this effect until the end of the slide. Then we have the head and light shape object, on which we have used the spin effect with a time duration of 1 second and a rotation of 10 degrees clockwise. Even though we want the head and light to move back to their original position, but still we have not applied the auto reverse effect. That is because we want a bit of delay while reversing them. So, for that, we again applied the spin effect with a delay timing of 3 seconds, and this time we are rotating it 10 degrees counterclockwise. The time duration is 1 second for this effect as well. Then we have the left hand, right hand, and the Jackleg machine, and we used the left motion path on these 3 shape objects. If we zoom into the slide, then you can notice that we have applied a very short length to this motion path, and if you look into the time duration, then it is just 0.05 seconds while repeating this effect until the end of the slide. We used this method to create a shaking effect. As we need to apply the same effect to both Miner's hand, instead of applying the effects from scratch, you can take the help of Animation Painter to replicate the same effect over hands. Now, let's talk about the smoke and fire particles. For each smoke shape object, we are using the diagonal motion path, grow shrink, and fade out animation effects. The only difference between the rest of the smoke particles is the delay timing. As we want each of them to appear after a bit of delay, we added a delay timing to those 3 effects. You can easily do that by replicating the same object and then just adding the delay timing to the effects. For grow shrink effect, we are using a 350% ratio with a time duration of 1 second and have applied the fade out effect with a time duration of half a second. You can note in the animation pane that each of the smoke objects has the same 3 animation effects with different delay timings. We used the same method for the fire particles as well. We used the arc, grow shrink, and fade out effects for each of them. If we showcase a few fire shape objects, then you can notice that we have just changed the position of the arc motion path, and you can do this by using the edit points from the effect options drop-down menu. You can also use custom motion path instead of arc if you want to. Again, all these fire particles have the same three animation effects but with different delay timings. Finally, if you look into the timeline of the animation pane, then the last animation effect ends at 5.50 seconds. So, from the transition tab, we set the advanced slide timings to 5.50 seconds. Then from the slideshow tab, click Setup Slideshow, and make a checkmark on the loop continuously until ESC option. Now, if you run the slideshow, then it will get played in a continuous loop. I hope you will find this tutorial informative and useful, and don't forget to like, share, comment, and subscribe. Thanks a lot for watching the video, and we will meet in our next tutorial. Bye and take care.